Yes, a very, very warm welcome to the OCBC Arena, the heart of the Singapore Sports Hub, for the first match of Day 3 of the Men's World Floorball Championships Qualification 2022 Asia-Oceania. This is Korea up against Japan. The Koreans have certainly been dominating this game thus far in the opening couple of minutes or so. Moving the ball around nicely, an attempt on goal, and the follow-up falls to Kim Seong-min. So Korea take the early advantage here in this matchup. 1-0, wonderfully worked goal. It was a late attempt saved by Takizawa, but Kim Seong-min was there to follow up. He did so nicely. It's Max Parbrand now. Rasmus Janssen with an attempt on goal. Off to Parbrand. Parbrand scores. And Korea now 2 goals to the good. Max Parbrand elated with that effort. He always finds himself in the right place at the right time. Today was no different. Rasmus Janssen smartly picking him out with a sweet pass. Parbrand making no mistake. It's Parbrand now on the left-hand flank. A nice move forward, cuts back. Dispossessed. Melvin Parbrand on to Max again, and unfurls an absolute tracer bullet. 3-0 to the Koreans. They are firmly in the driver's seat in this Group G clash against Japan. Wow, what an effort by Max Parbrand. He can put no foot wrong, using those long levers and executing to perfection. Takizawa in the goal. Well, couldn't do much. It's Japan on the offensive, trying to pull one back before the end of this first period. Oh, and they do. That's an absolutely stupendous goal from Aichi Takizawa. Really against the run of play. Great drag, great turn. Fooled his marker. Fooled the Korean keeper. Korea now on the attack. Trying to restore the lead, and they have done just that. It's Kim Tae-woo, the number 9. Well set up by Melvin Parbrand. What a pass that was. Instinctive, accurate, precise. Kim Tae-woo was there to do the business. Korea 4, Japan 3. Japan pull off the unthinkable here. It'd be remarkable if they could score. And that's exactly what they've done. Hiromasa Segusa with his brace. A second goal for the number 6. And would you believe it? If you didn't think this match had any more twists and turns left, well, think again, because Hiromasa Segusa, wow, what an effort. He went for the jugular, it worked. And it's 4-4. Welcome to Game 2 of Day 3, the Men's World Floorball Championships Qualification 2022 Aofc between Malaysia and New Zealand. Malaysia now, a quick turnover. Desmond Das, Tristan Tan fires a shot in and puts the Malaysians in the early lead. What a goal that was. Malaysia have been attacking with great intent, and it's paid off. Desmond Das, Tristan Tan, a picture of concentration. Knows that it's still very early on, but Malaysia have the early advantage. Here's New Zealand now looking to restore parity. Alex Stewart does just that. A magnificent goal from distance. We saw the Kiwis practicing these shots in training ahead of the match, but Alex Stewart has converted in style. A wonderful goal, and New Zealand very, very happy with that success. New Zealand on the charge again. Can they make it 2-1? Yep, they certainly can. It's Russell Hurst. That was ably assisted by James Matheson. So New Zealand, just like that, have turned things around and lead 2-1 now. Here's Alex Stewart. On to Archie Costlin. Archie Costlin fires from distance, and he too gets on the score sheet. Timothy McKibben providing the assist, and Costlin going for the jugular. From nearly the halfway line, the keeper was offside. It's New Zealand 3. On New Zealand early in the third period. Timothy McKibben gets on the score sheet. Wow, that would have certainly shocked the Malaysians. Just under a minute into this final 15, McKibben makes it 5-3 to the Kiwis. Here's McKibben again. Oh, wow, what a move that was. It's Alex Stewart with his second of the afternoon. A marauding run. He passed it down beautifully to McKibben. McKibben fed him again, and Stewart was there in the right place at the right time to tap in. So 6-3 to the Kiwis. Malaysia need to fight back with the goal, and they've done that. It's Desmond Das, Tristan James with his hat-trick. 6-4. Malaysia still in it. They'll be hoping that that goal inspires some confidence in the Malaysian charges. Kiwis, if they can get a 7th, they'll be mighty proud. And McKibben has ensured that they have. So 7-4 to the Kiwis. They've restored the 3-goal advantage. And surely now they have secured victory. Here's Malaysia now on the attack, perhaps the final attack. It's Zephaniah Chong. What a goal that is. Lifting it over the keeper, short back lift. Finishing off in style. Clinical. Little too late for the Malaysians. New Zealand 7, Malaysia 5.
Welcome to the third match of day 3 of the Men's World Floorball Championships qualification 2022 AOFC. This is a big one between Australia and the Philippines. So still deadlocked in this crucial Group G encounter between Australia and the Philippines. Australians have been more dominant, and here they go. Daniel Gardner, the skipper, putting the green and gold in front. There was a smart assist from Liam Perry. And Gardner dragging into the center and unleashing a thunderbolt, leaving Victor Lindberg with absolutely no chance. The Australians go ahead early here in the first period. Good attempt on goal. And now the Philippines on the counter. It's Melvin Mendoza with a turn and spin. And he puts the Philippines on parity. A lovely assist through ball from Lucas Oival Perez, the skipper. And Mendoza, as he's done on so many occasions in the past, will not miss from such a close distance through the legs of Ryan Alexandrakis in goal. Philippines 1, Australia 1. Philippines now looking to attack, consolidate. Perhaps grab the lead, well intercepted by Melvin Mendoza. And looks like that is an own goal from Jordan Noel. A rather unfortunate deflection into the back of his own net. Well, really not what the Australians had expected, but the Philippines will take it. Mendoza celebrating. It was the pressure applied by Team Philippines here. And unfortunately for Jordan Noel, well, these things happen. Philippines now, guns are blazing. All out attack. Here's Kim Varga. Back to Perez. Perez against the boards. Back to Varga. Varga turns around and, oh wow, that is a magnificent piece of individual skill from Kim Varga. He can do absolutely no wrong. Wonderful piece of work here, leaving everyone astounded and shocked. Varga puts the Philippines in front. Here we go, face off. Oh wow, the Australians have pulled one back through Thomas Gardner. Just seconds after the restart, Gardner found himself in some space and converted in style. Fantastic shot, Victor Lindberg. Wasn't able to do much about that. Hit at such high velocity. Here are the Philippines. And there it is, the final whistle is blown. The Philippines have been absolutely dominant. A
welcome to what is looking to be a really exciting matchup here as the Fast and Pacey Team Thailand take on Team Singapore. This is game four of day three in the qualification. Thailand really in attack mode. Oh, that skirmish, and it's right through. Chirubutyamyum has just opened up the scoring for Team Thailand as he makes it 1-0. Team Singapore was just struck there by that effort from Chirubutyamyum. Right place at the right time, just had to drive that home. Here's Renfok to tight it, and that's touch and go. What an absolutely phenomenal shot here from the Thailand captain. It's now 2-0. What a team these lads form. Rinfok receiving it from Pimpa to Tidet, and it's straight on. Well, here's Pawa Tidet. And Chirubut Yamyum gets his second. So Yamyum has scored to put Thailand 3 goals up. Pawa Tidet, oh, he's leading his team like a true leader. Lovely finish there from Chirubut. Simon Johansson, Kirwan Noisoy will run away with it, and he slotted that home. So it's now 4-0. Noisoy just providing the spoils there, and early a bit of damage against Team Singapore in, well, that second period. Here's Damien Wan. Oh, that's got to be tragedy. Absolute tragedy here for Team Singapore as Damien Wan goes in for the throw. And the ball just slipped through and it spun back through his legs. An own goal, and it's now 5-0. Well, Thailand will celebrate that goal, but I can't help but feel bad for Damien Wan. Here's Tidet. And that's exactly what happened. Wan, of course, unable to pull off that throw. Well, have it all to do here. They still haven't got a goal, Genmark. And that is a fantastic shot from Zhang Jiaqing. So Zhang Jiaqing, one of the debutants in the team who made his entry just recently, the day before yesterday, and scored on debut, has once again found the back of the net. It's now 8-1. Well, that wasn't going to happen. The goal exposed with 6 men on for Team Singapore, and they've been punished. Pawa Tidet decides to knock in another one, and that's the second hat-trick that we've seen for Team Thailand, as Pawa Tidet also scores his third to match teammate Thirawat Noisoy. It's 9-1 now. And that's how it's finished. Thailand 9, Singapore 1, with Thailand qualifying directly for the World Championships. Of course, they will be in action again on Saturday when they go up against the Philippines for the best team in this qualification process.